Hey guys, Byzer here. Time to find out what's going on in our next episode of the MPL, the Major Pokemon League. My camera is moving on its own for some reason. There we go. We're going up against Danicky, aka the coach of the St. Louis Sableyes. He is also a good friend of mine, as everyone else is in the MPL. This is our week number 7 battle. My camera just wants to keep moving. Alright, can you just like stay still? Please, camera? Okay, well, whatever. We'll just leave you like that. After a very heartbreaking loss last week because... Okay, camera. I'm gonna need you to... Alright, we'll just go like that. Yeah? That's good. Alright. Sorry about that. After a heartbreaking loss to the Sacramento Kings last week, we're going up against Dan, so hopefully we can get a win. I'm going to hit that Battle Star button since I've taken a while to talk, but I'll just go over with the team. We've got our Choice Scarf, Kurumu, Staraptor. We have our Eviolite, specially defensive Porygon. Right? Yes. We have our leftover Swords Dancing Scissor. We have our Physical Bulk Celebi with the Calm Mind Substitute combination, so we're going to see if that's going to pop up. We have our Choice Scarf Rotom. That's right, run double Scarfers. So hopefully we can fake out and, show off one of these Scarfers to make Dan think we're... That's our only Scarfer. We'll see. And then we have our offensive Swampert with the Stealth Rocks. So we're going to hit that Party Pokemon button and see what we're going to have in store for us against Danny Boy. And he is bringing some mons that I thought he was going to bring. Yeah, pretty much what I thought he was going to bring. Please don't drop on the floor. Okay, good. Silly stylus. Pretty much what I thought he was going to bring. Okay, so he's bringing the Mega Medi. He's got the Magnezone. He's got the Armaldo. The biggest thing is the Goodra. That's the one thing that I really, really have issues with on my team. Of course he brings his mascot, of course he does, and a Tornadus. So I'm predicting that his Tornadus is probably going to be Scarfed, just because I outspeed everything on his, he outspeeds everything on my team with that. So that's definitely a possibility for that thing being Scarfed. There's no reason for it not to be. Could be a Salt Vest, but I'm thinking just off the bat, based on the team that I'm looking at here, that's probably Scarfed. So who do I want to lead with? I can lead with Swampert to get up the rocks. Yeah. That could be possible. That could be a thing. That could definitely be a thing. Luckily, he did not bring the Nidoqueen, so we can freely Voltage. Yeah, I think I'm gonna lead with Swampert just to get up the rocks. We'll just do that. We'll just do that as time runs down. We'll just do that. Always, it takes so long to think about the Tamons that they're bringing before I can think about what I actually want to start. I need to work on that, but we're obviously not gonna work on that today because we're in the middle of a battle. But anywho. Let's see, Danny Boy. What you got for us? What you got for us? Who are you going to lead with? You're going to lead with his Magnezone. Okay. So that's actually a... HP Grass. HP Grass. That is a thing. I'm going to take that out of my mouth now because that was gross. Magnezone, Choice Specs, HP Grass. Okay, because that's level 100 and I'm level 50. I'm like, what? Why does HP Fire do 50%? Okay, so let's see. Hidden Power Grass, I'm shaking. Choice Specs. Yeah, that kills me. That kills me. That definitely, why? Why does it not let me change you to 50? Yep, HP Grass definitely kills me. If he's not Specs, and let's just see, whatever, Air Balloon. Yeah, HP Grass does not kill me. So the question is he Specs? I can obviously, I can switch out into Porygon. Can't actually hit this thing though. I can switch out into my Celebi. Okay. You know, let's just find out. We're gonna EQ. Okay, he does not have the HP grass. He's gonna go out into Tornadus probably. Oh no. He's gonna go out into his Gudra. Alright. So the Magnezone most likely has the eight. Whoa there! Whoa there, Nelly! Whoa there! Alrighty then, that did a butt ton of damage. Holy crap! Holy crap! That did so much damage to that Gudra. Holy. Holy crap. Who would he switch in? Maybe the Torn. Maybe the Torn. Should I just Ice Punch? I think I'm just gonna Ice Punch. Oh, okay, he's got Power Whip. Alright. Alright. That I'm actually okay with. I'm actually okay with that because that did a huge, huge chunk of damage to the Gudra. And I'm okay with that. Okay. Okay, I forgot the Gudra got Power Whip, actually. I did. So that's my bad, Dan. Gudra kills Swampert. Well, that's unfortunate, though. That's unfortunate, Swampert. Leg Day did not do what it wanted to do. Okay, though. And go out into Gudra. Yeah, Gudra has to be scissors, so that's a thing. That's definitely a thing. Can go out into my Staraptor and Brave Bird. Which I think I'm gonna do. Yeah, I'm gonna go out into Staraptor. I'm gonna go out into Staraptor. And how much does a U-turn do? Let's see here. Staraptor custom set. U-turn does nothing because again that's a level 100 Gudra. It's about a roll to kill. That's a roll. It does 29 to 34%. Okay. If I do Brave Bird, then he goes out into Magnezone. And I can go out into Celebi, I suppose. Or I can close combat. Could drop a Draco. Let's just U-turn, let's see. Okay, he does withdraw, so that's good. So we will get the Ultima, the Cofagrigus. Alright, so this is probably a defensive. Yeah, that's defensive, alright. Well, that is a defensive Cofagrigus. Okay. Okay. And then no, Cofagrigus is gonna have Will-O-Wisp. It's gonna have the Will-O-Wisp. Let's see here. Rotom. You can Shadow Ball. I don't want that Choice Scarf knocked off, that's the thing. And I don't want to go out into... this is a ticky. This is a tricky one. I think I'm gonna go out into... No, that's stupid. I was gonna say, I'm gonna go out into Porygon too, but no knockoff! That's a thing! Yeah, I'm gonna go into Celebi. I'm gonna go into Celebi. Because I want to get some damage off onto this Cofagrigus. Lefties, okay. So that means it's gonna, yeah. Lefties. Alrighty then. The question though is, what does this thing want to do? It's either gonna knock off. Let me see how much. How much does a knockoff do if he does do a knockoff? Pen, what are you doing, Pen? Pen, stop. Alright, Celebi. Custom set. Kofag. Defensive. 50. Jeez, really? Alrighty then, what if I get up to plus one, Shadow Ball does about that much. Let's set up a Calm Mind. I wanna see what he wants to do. I don't wanna reveal the substitute yet. Okay, there's the Shadow Ball. So let's see. That does about, what did that do? Did 60. Did 147. So it did about a little bit of a percentage. Did about a little bit of a percentage. Did about a little bit of a percentage. So now I think I'm gonna set up a sub. Damn. I was hoping he would switch or Willow. Oh. That hits behind sub? Well, that's kind of silly. Well, that's kind of stupid that hits behind sub. Alright. Well. Okay, I guess that's a thing. So this has Haze. Shadow Ball. Alright, so I guess we can go for a Shadow Ball now. Go for a Shadow Ball now. See how much damage that does? Not that much at all. Alrighty. Oh, but we do get the special defense drop. Which is a bit unfortunate. Well, it is a bit unfortunate. That is a bit unfortunate for the Danster. I think I'm going to set up another Calm Mind, to be honest. And then I will Shadow Ball again. Yeah, I think that's what we're going to do. I know he's probably going to Shadow Ball again right now. So this is very interesting what's happening. Very, very interesting. Oh, okay. Alrighty. Alrighty then. So we're gonna play this game here, huh? Alright, so I know he's got Destiny Bond, so he's got the D-Bond. Dan loves to run his D-Bond. Okay. So he's probably gonna go for another Haze, so let's go for Substitute again. just to get that up. Yep, there's the Haze. So now... Now I don't think a Shadow Ball shouldn't kill, so I'm going to Shadow Ball. Since I'm not at plus one. So we'll do some damage to it. Yep, okay. Good, good, good. What? Back-to-back special defense drops. Oh, Dan, I am so sorry. I am so sorry. That's really... really on the unfortunate side. Let's see. Now that that's at that. Yeah, I don't think a Giga Drain's still gonna kill. So we're just gonna have to... We're just gonna Shadow Ball again. Cause that should definitely kill. Now I was gonna withdraw. I was thinking about subbing too. He's gonna sack off his Amethyst, maybe. Oh wow, that literally does nothing. Okay. So that's a Salt Vest? Yeah, that was probably a Salt Vest. To be honest. So let's see. Hoodra, Assault Vest. Let's see. Fire Blast does about that much. At plus one. Yeah, okay. That's a good thing I didn't go for Giga Drain, because it's probably got Sap Sipper. What do I want to do here? If I had Psychic, I'd go for that, but I don't. I know he's probably gonna go for a Fire Blast, or he could drop a Draco. That's always a thing. He'd always drop a Draco. I'm going to Porygon 2. I think that's the safest bet. Yeah, I'm gonna switch into Porygon 2, because I can, switch into Porygon 2. He's either dropping a Draco or going for the Flamethrowers. Oh, he's got Gooey, okay. Alright, good to know. There's a Fire Blast. Yeah, okay. Fire Blast. Power Whip. Alrighty then, I'm just gonna go for Toxic. And we'll see what he's probably, honestly, he's probably gonna switch into Magnezone. Which is why this is kind of unfortunate. I would love for you to switch out into your, he's probably gonna go into Magnezone. No, okay. It goes into the Armaldo. Okay. We get a Toxic off, at least. Well, that's good. Well, that's good. I know he's gonna knock off now. Now he's gonna knock off. He's gonna knock off. Does Porygon 2 serve any purpose? Honestly, Tornadus, that's about the only thing that serves a purpose for. That's it. I was saying, like, if I sacrifice the Eviolite. Let me see how much Porygon to my set. I'm specially defensive. Now I have, do have some defensive bulk. Armaldo, normal set 50, knockoff. It doesn't do that much, honestly. But then I lose my EV light. Yeah. Alright, well, we're just gonna recover. I know he's gonna knock off. Oh, I outspeed. Oh yeah, because I'm a Porygon too. Of course I outspeed. That was silly. Oh, he went for Stealth Rocks. Okay. So rocks are up. That's good to know. Okay. Okay. I guess we'll just Ice Beam then. I guess, yeah, I do outspeed this Fortissimo because it's not that... Not that, what's the word I'm looking for? Oh, I forgot about Gooey. I have the Gooey. So, yeah, that definitely helps me because I already was so, so much on the slower side than this Armaldo. Shoo. He's probably just gonna let Armaldo go down. So I'm gonna try attack so I can see if I can get a recover off next turn. Try attack will do some damage. Oh, that might actually put him in range where Toxic's gonna kill, to be honest. Oh! Porygon 2 avoids. Let's see. So if Toxic doesn't kill, it does kill, so that miss does matter. I'm so sorry, Dan. But trust me, I know exactly how you feel in regards to the hacks. I'm sorry. The special defenses dropped obviously mattered because I mean you can do as much damage as you wanted to on my Celebi, and then now that Stone Edge Misc did end up mattering. Okay, so there is the Medichams. There is the Medichams. So Porygon 2 takes down P2, kills Armaldo. Alrighty, so Yep, and now that Magnezone is free reign to do things, well, that's a little bit unfortunate. So I need to actually check out some things and stuff here. So let's see. Scissor. My set versus Medicham. Oh, you all out attacker. Wow, high jump kick actually kills. Oh my god, this thing is broken. This thing is broken. This thing is broken. Oh my gosh. Bullet punch. Yeah, bullet punch is about 50%, so that's a thing. This thing is broken. Alright, well, I guess we're just gonna let... Yeah, we'll just let P2 go down. We'll just, we'll let P2 go down. We'll see if that's a mistake or not. We're gonna let P2 go down. I don't have any switch into this. I don't have a switch into this. Even my defensive, thank god you didn't miss that, Dan. Thank you for not missing that. Oh, well now then, this changes things. This actually changes things. This actually changes things somewhat. This actually changes things somewhat. So let's see it. Minus one. Actually need to see some calculators here. Okay, so 152 times 0.67. Oh, is that right? Minus one. Minus one does is a minus 0.5. So it's dividing it by. So you multiply by 1.5. Yeah, so it's about that much. I don't think scissor outspeeds. Don't think that scissor outspeeds. No, you don't. You don't. Okay, now is when I really wish I had leg day still. I can go out into Rotom and Hydro Pump. Yeah. Gudra is still a thing. Gudra is definitely still a thing. I'm going to Celebi. And I'm going to go into Celebi. I'm going to Celebi. And I'm going to get off a Giga Drain. I'm going to get off the draining of the Gigas. Yeah, let's just go for that. I haven't actually revealed that I have the Giga Drain, but I have revealed that I have Calm Mind, Substitute, and Shadow Ball. So I obviously either have a Psychic-type move or a Grass-type move. So now that he is at minus one thanks to the Gooey, I will outspeed. So that is definitely a thing. And his Giga Drain should do a decent chunk, so he's going to stay in. He's probably got the Ice Punch. Giga Drain does about half. I needed to do actually just a little bit more. He's got Fire Punch, okay. So that's good to know. We're just going to live. No burn, luckily. Alrighty then. But Bullet Punch. Bullet Punch is a thing. So he's got High Jump Kick. Fire Punch for the Scissor. Most likely got the Bullet Punch, which is most likely what he's gonna go for right now. I'm actually gonna switch out into Rotom, predicting the Bullet Punch. The Celebi, I think, can still be useful. Bullet Punch or another Fire Punch. Either is coming this way. Oh, he's gonna withdraw. Okay. And go out into the Gudra. Alrighty then. Alrighty then. Yeah, that's unfortunate. That's unfortunate. That's really unfortunate. Because I'm not gonna be able to kill this thing. See what I mean about Gudra being a pain in my ass? This is exactly what I meant about Gudra being a pain in my ass. Because I can't touch it. I cannot touch it. Okay, Rotom. My set. Stop being retarded, TV. Thank you. Okay, let's see here. So, Hydro Pump probably does like 6 HP. Yeah, it does. Like 6 HP. How much does a Shadow Ball do? Probably not that much either. Yep, exactly the same amount as a Hydro Pump. So that's, yeah, okay. Yeah. Alrighty then. So if I Volt Switch, I guess I sack off Celebi. So that was pointless. Yeah, that was pretty pointless. That was pretty pointless, to be honest. That's gonna do like 2 HP of damage. This is clearly a max special defense assault vested Gudra. That was the thing that I did. That was definitely a thing that I did. So we'll go into Celebi. There was the Power Whip. Okay. Wow. Oh, I'm sorry, Dan. I am, but you're still gonna kill the, Celebi's still gonna go down, so we're gonna go for a Shadow Ball. And, wow, I don't feel good about this. I mean, Dan, you're still beating me, because, yeah, you're still beating me. So there's that, even with all the hacks, which is good on your part. Just shows how an amazing battler you are. You have me on the ropes still, so that's good for you. Not good for me. Even with all this hacks in my favor, which I'm very sorry about. I don't like hacks, as you guys have known for my first 6 battles in the League Thunderbolt. Okay. So we've seen the T-Bolt. Interesting. Okay. Now we can do a thing. Well, here's the thing, though. Do I have U-Turn on my Scissor? I don't remember. Did I pack U-Turn or did I fail? I think I failed and didn't put U-turn. No, I didn't put U-turn. That was so stupid on my part not putting U-turn, because I would have U-turned right there. Actually, no, that was stupid. Why would I U-turn right there? Why would I U-turn right there? That would make literally no sense whatsoever. That would literally make no sense whatsoever to U-turn right there. But what I am going to do is U-turn right here. We are going to U-turn right here. We'll just let a little amethyst go down. And then... Oh, he's going to keep it. Alright. Go out into this thing once again. Alright. Alright, now... Are you in range for a knockoff kill? That's the thing, are you? What has he got? He's Shadow Ball Debond. I don't think he's got... He could have Willow. I know he's got Haze, so yeah, that's a thing. That's a thing. Okay. Knock off. Onto the Kafag. Are you defensive? Okay. Knockoff does 41 to 50%. So that looks like about 41 to 50%. Yeah, that's max. Yeah, so... Yeah, this should kill. So that's good. That's good. Oh no, lefties. Oh, I forgot lefties. Okay, now we're at a roll. Oh. Ew. Okay. Huh. I should have just went into Rotom. That was stupid. Where's Life Orb? Okay. If he willows me... Yeah, I have to... I just have to go for it. We're just gonna see the roll right now, And the roll does not go in my favor. And here comes a Willow, most likely. Nope, there's the Debond. Okay. Interesting. Okay, you're not packing the Willow, then. Your Pain Split? What the heck is your last move? Haze Shadow Ball Debond. I don't know what your last move is then. Okay, well then, I know how to deal with the Kafagrigus and the Debons. Okay, there's the Pain Split. Okay, so Pain Split is his last move. Good to know. Pain Split. But now, I am actually free to start swords dancing up here. So Shadow Ball's gonna do about that much, so I should be able to live a Shadow Ball. I'm gonna set up another swords dance, which he'll probably just haze again. Actually, I just thought about it. Yeah, he'll probably just haze again, to be honest. Yeah, there's the haze. Okay, go for it. Use up all your PPs and whatnot. Can knock off now. Hmm. hate stally crap. I hate stally crap. Let's just knock off now. We'll see how much that does. It's obviously not going to kick out. It's going to take him down to that range. He's going to go for a Shadow Ball this time. Dang it, I should have Swords Danced. Okay, that did... I wasn't paying attention to what my HP was at. So I'm at 66 now. Which is 37%. So I should live another snog. I should have Swords Dance right there. Why did I not Swords Dance? Why did I not Swords Dance? Yeah, Swords Dance now. That was so stupid. That was a big fuck up on my part. I should have just Swords Danced right there. Yep, that was that. Because then this thing would be dead, obviously. Then this thing would be dead. So he's probably going to Pain Split again. Because we're going to be super annoying. He's either going to Pain Split or he's going to Haze. That's the thing. He's going to do one of those. But if he Pain Splits, or if he hazes, he's not going to haze. He's going to, he might haze. Yeah, he's going to haze. He's got to. Oh, Dan, if you don't. If you Pain Split right now, if you Pain Split, I'm going to be mad. I'm gonna go into Rotom. Oh, if you Pain Split right now, Dan, then you just super pro played me. Okay, good. Good. He goes for the haze. Okay, now will a Rotom. Custom set. Volt switch. That should kill. Should definitely kill. Yes, it should. Yes, it should. He's probably gonna sack off Goodra, though. That's the thing. He's gonna sack off Goodra, then he can easily just go out into Magnezone. That's the thing. Okay, if I Volt Switch, he's either going to sack off Goodra or this thing. If he sacks off Goodra, I Volt Switch. I go into Staraptor, he goes into either Tornadus or Magnezone. He wouldn't go into Magnezone, that'd be silly. He would go into Tornadus, probably. But I don't think I have a choice, to be honest, unless I Hydro. I guess that's always a thing. But Shadow Ball, does that help me at all? Yeah, I'm just gonna Hydro. Alright, so we get the Hydro off, which is going to take out the Ultima. So this annoying poopy thing is gone. Alright, Rotom kills Kefag. I missed out someone that killed something on my team. Yeah, Guja kills Swampert, Medicham kills P2. Who killed Celebi? Was it Goodra? Yeah, it was Goodra. Yeah, it was Goodra. Yep, yes, it was Goodra. Goodra kills Celebi. Interesting. Interessante. What are we doing here? Okay, well that does, yeah, that does the thing. Okay, hydro. Yeah, that definitely does some things. Which is a bit unfortunate. So this thing might be scarfed, actually. Alright. Hydro does connect, so that's luckily. We don't actually know if this thing is... Whoa! That was a crit. We do know its specs. Okay. Because... Yeah, it's probably... Or it's either analytic. Not entirely sure, to be honest. Okay. Oh my god, the hacks on Dan's side and he's still mollywopping me. So that's down. He's still got Gudra at like 6 HP. Magnezone has 1 HP. It wasn't sturdy. I didn't see the sturdy unless... I don't know. We can go to Scissor. Bullet Punch. And Bullet Punch. And Bullet Punch. Yeah, I suppose that's the thing. It's Tornadus, though. That's the thing. I needed to get damage off on the Tornadus. Did I get damage off on the Medicham? I don't remember. I think I did, actually. I'm not sure. This is where I wish I was Life Orb. Yeah, so we'll just go for the bullet punch. No reason not to. Yeah, take out the Magnezone. Had 1 HP. Alright, so Scissor kills Mag. And then, had I Swords Danced? Yeah, I don't think it would have mattered, because obviously the Magnezone would have been able to come in and go for the HP Fire that it most likely has. Yeah, there's Chaser. Okay. Alright, so the, this is where I wish I had rocks up. This is where 9,999 straight wins on the Battle Mace on, huh, Dan? That's legit. Yeah, so here comes a Heat Wave. And, I don't think I can win, to be honest. I don't think so here. I need to see what I can do here. Staraptor, if I was Choice Banded Staraptor, then this would be a different biscuit. To be honest. Let's see. Tornadus. Whatever. 50. We're adamant. And, quick attack. Yep, that's not gonna do shit. Well, that's unfortunate. Yeah, we just have to obviously go for the bullet punch. There's no reason to not. It's gonna do about that much. There goes the hurricane. It connects. Good job. No reason for it to hope. Thankfully, it didn't. It didn't miss. If it did miss, then that would have. Okay, he's Life Orb. Oh. 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 Oh, what? Huh. I think he wins on the fake out. Pretty sure he wins on the fake out. Oh my god, it's a roll. Holy crap. Okay. Hold on here. Okay. Oh, that did way too much recoil. What the heck? Let's see. Oh, I should actually live. Wait. Hold on here. Oh, I should live this. Unless he's packing Bullet Punch 2. Entirely possible. If he's got the Bullet Punch, then he's obviously won it. Oh, he's won it either way, because Gudra... Oh my god, he's won it either way. Yeah. Damn it. Why? You won it either way. You won it either way, because the recoil would have taken me out, Dan. There was no reason for that switch. I mean, it doesn't matter in the end, but, yeah. Yeah, it doesn't matter in the end, because you packed the fake out. So, not entirely sure what that switch was. Oh, man. That was a close one. That was a close one. If we didn't have fake out, then we would have won. Oh, man. That's unfortunate. If he wasn't packing the fake out, we would have won. I don't know what that switch was. There was no reason for it. Medicham kills Star Raptor, and if I hadn't let him get up the rocks, or if I had defog on Scissor or something, we would have won that. That's that's the way the cookie crumbles, I suppose. Tornadus kills Scissor. Dan played really risky in the end there, going for the Hurricane on the Scissor. Because had that missed, then I'm pretty sure it would have been all over. Yeah, I would have won. Yeah, I would have won, because I would have been able to Bullet Punch again, which could have taken out the Tornadus or not, and then he could have killed me the next turn. Then I would have gone into Straptor, and the Brave Birds wouldn't have done as much damage, and I might have lived the double fake out. Because it would have literally done like 1 HP of damage. Yeah. 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 Alright, well. Anyway, I guess Dan is tired of me sitting there on the screen. He's gonna DC. But anyway, I hope you guys enjoyed. That was a very good battle. And make sure you go check out Dan's channel. His link will be in the description down below. So make sure you go and check out him and see his side of the battle. But anyway, I hope you guys enjoyed. If you did, please sear that like button down below. And of course, hit that subscribe button. Also, remember to click the link in the description to follow me on Twitter, and I guess I will see you guys later.